divine Lord today, ask Him of that Lord, hey now, with your grace and blessings once more, may you give this family the inner strength to deal with the external reality, and that inner strength, my dear devotees, and oh Lord, to that external reality, the reality of separation, in this case of death, today we ask of that Lord to give us that inner strength, so we can deal with the external reality. As we bow our heads and pray, close our eyes and pray, we pray for a few moments of contemplation. Together with Nick, we'll perform the meeting. the same right as if the body was really open. This is called effigy. And the coach grass is that representation because of the period that we are not allowed to see. So what happens, we take a coach grass, which is the embodiment of consciousness, and we wrap it into a form of a body for the welfare. We perform the rites, the same rites, as if we do it on the real body. So the purpose of the funeral rite devotees, Panchatattva Shanti, the elements that make up the body, we act of that law, when the elements enter back into the atmosphere, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, we are familiar with the same. So for the elements to enter back the body, all our bodies are made of five elements, Panch Tattva, and that is the, hence that is the fundamental purpose of performing the rites. So first there will be young man, Bain. Oh, Ramesh will guide you. Oh, Mama Kabutrasya, Kashyap Gotrasya, Om Anil Manick, Pratasya, Pindu Maya Deyate Taho Pratishya Dham. many dollars from them. I don't know if they have a guy on the sutra.
So when his wife was at work, he was at home taking care of his son. So, that sense he was lucky because he got to witness all of Nikhil's moving milestone. And I always remember when Charlie used to be, even when Nikhil was a baby, they have a mattress right in the living room and they used to play fights. Right? So watch his professional life now, which is more impressive. When he was 19 years and 4 months, he got called to the training bar at 19 years and 4 months. Huh? So 6 months later, that is 2 months before he turned 20 years, he became a full-fledged police officer. That was very impressive. Before you turn 20 years, you are a full-fledged police officer. And you know when people at that age, they become police officers, and sometimes one traffic book functions in one day. Well, I think I don't think about 2 traffic books in one day. I'm not too sure. I remember his first appointment was in Barco Division. I also know about, I think, the Sarawak substation, Grand Hoover, Freeport, Las Vegas, and then where you eventually settled down at Chihuahua. Now, another impressive thing about his career was the speed at which he achieved his promotions. Now, 14 years after he became a full-fledged police officer, he became corporal. That was in 2006. I think, well, I'm not too sure what he did, but I think 2 years after, in 2008, he became sergeant. And then, probably around 2018 or so, I'm not too sure, till 2018, he became inspector. And at the time of his passing, he was acting assistant superintendent. All known accomplished at the age of 48. And we can't say what will happen, but if he had lived his whole life, lived to retirement at least, we don't know what rank he would have achieved. And I remember this very well. When he achieved all his ranks, it's like nobody knew. He didn't tell anybody. I had to find out to be great guy that through my own contractor, I had to find out he was up in ASP. So, and I mean, that was very, don't go to him. I mean, from where he was at the beginning, where he finished 3 ticket books in 1 day, to the point of where he just, as our officer said in the papers, that he was a gentle giant and he didn't talk much. I think that was certainly the name of the guy. He didn't really talk much. And he kept it up on him to himself, and he probably told his wife, he was a doctor person from Tila. And I know coming to the end, he was very liked in the police service. I know coming to the end, yeah. So that was my actual witness to his achievements, both professional and personal. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, G. So we have tribute, and then right after we just follow the words of comfort from the TTPS. So everybody give a buffer. We have a time calculation left. Where is the time we need to leave here? 12:45. I knew Anil, or at least the following officer, for almost 20 years. And to summarize his time with us, it's very difficult. 20 years is a very long time. When the news broke of his passing, soon thereafter, the TTPS paid a very commendable tribute to their colleague. I want to thank them for that. My remembrance of him is as a friend and not as a police. And as far as I knew about him, he kept his police life, family life, and outside life separate and apart. When I started my career, I met Anil through some friends, all of whom resided in Central. And from that time to now, the same how much we learned, how many places we went, what we do, what we didn't do, I don't think he would want me to divulge all that information.
Please don't.
Especially the presence of all these officers. But I will say, we had some fantastic times. I was an honest, simple, humble person. And he would have been contented for me just to say that and nothing more. And to be his friend meant he would call you every day. Just to say what we could do, what's the plan, what them boys up to. On weekends or when we would have a line, so many people would say to me, Officer Passing through for them. To be his friend meant he knew your family. And then knew my family. And to his other friends, he knew their entire families as well. Anil never liked the showy lifestyle. And even when he got married, he opted for the traditional wedding. He did, however, like many of us, have advice. And that advice was cards. Since I know Anil, we play cards together. We play all of us all over different places. And also in his free time, he would play roaming all over Central. To say whether he won or it was profitable, it was only he could tell that. In fact, there was this one time when we went to play a pet match, and halfway in the game, I got a phone call that there were armed officers outside my house. They wanted to see me, and they wanted to see my car. And when I told them, I had to report to the Freeport police station immediately. And when I told them, we went, and when we went to the station, he told me to stay in the car. And about 5 minutes after, then he called. But it turned out that day there was a robbery, and I witness gave my number plates. Fortunately for me that day, the police officer picked me up from home and I didn't drive my car for the day and night. So, and I chose to share this because he looked out for the well-being of a lot of people. And if people needed some advice or guidance, he was willing to assist them at any time. During the time he was at home, which was a very stressful time for him, and he said, I don't know why he's pressure about it. I was telling him, I said, well, you're home. You get to see a child grow. Enjoy your time. When things go back to normal, they will see. They will wish you were home. And he was like, he didn't think about it like that. So in closing, I want to express a couple sentiments from some persons he knew. Jade and Allison, we have known Anil for over 20 years, and during that time we made a lot of fun memories. Most outstanding memory for me, Allison, was playing all those at our favorite blind spot, and he really enjoyed the whole of a Dallas suit. For Jade, would be Tobago trips and countless river lines. Most importantly, he was there for the times that mattered, like birth of his son Jody. Most present in this room was Anil. We didn't speak up. He was a good friend. Another person said, boy, just the other day we meet up and talk. I have no words. Another person said, Inspector Manick was a good man. He had been to assist his friends in any way he could. I felt safe he was around and he was a good line partner. His presence was surely this. Anil's passing was sudden. But his time with all of us mattered, and more importantly, he made a difference. To attempt to understand how and why this has happened, I don't think we will be able to. But to believe and pray that this is part of something that is bigger and more meaningful will help us to accept and move forward one day at a time. So on behalf of all his friends, so many, too many names of all, those who are online, those abroad, all the card players, I would like to say to Tal and his son and all his relatives that we extend our sincerest condolences to his family and relatives, and to say that we too share your loss. So until such time, until we see each other again. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we would like to invite members of the TTBS to bring their thoughts and stand with us.
Thank you, Minister. Good evening, all. I'm the Senior Superintendent, Kurt Simon, Secretary of Division. I just want to bring our condolences to the family. This is Manick. Thank you. From the Commissioner of Police, of course, and the Executive of the Transportation Police Service, of course, the Administration and the Central Division. I met Manick there at Central Division in March last year, and found him to be, just as you described, a very humble, polite, and quiet person. And I'm here today, after knowing him for just over 1 year, to just bring some words of comfort to his family, to his witnesses, I'd like to extend those words of comfort also to his friends, the extended family, of course, and our colleagues. I'm going to be very brief because I hear the time that we need to be running with. And just have 3 words I just want to leave with your family. Faith, hope, and love. Faith in God, Mrs. Manick. Faith in God that he exists. Hope for our best future that he has for you. He does have that in mind for both of you, family and friends. And love. Love God with all your heart and your mind and your strength. And love your neighbor. And it's these simple practices, I'm sure, will take you through even through this moment of grief. And this is from the same words that the officers of the Central Division will be going through this moment of grief, because we too, we understand your pain. You have lost a brother, you have lost a colleague, you have lost a friend. We understand your pain. You have lost others too in this COVID situation. We are all unable to mourn as we are accustomed to in our beautiful Trinidadian state. We are unable to express how we truly feel and the thing that our cultures allow us to do. But still, we have faith, we have hope, we have love. We watch those that I leave for you, Mrs. Manick. Thank you.
Thank you,
competent words from the tribute from his colleagues and also the TBS. I want to say to the seniors and to all the officers here, please continue doing your duties and please be safe at the same time. Before we conclude my deliberations, before I tell you what the Lord indicated in our scriptures about life and death, you know, there are two fun things I remember about Anil. Make sure you always have a puja. Make sure you give God thanks. Make sure you care about his wife. After Mark, together with his in-laws, Navin, and others. And the other thing that I always admire about him, whenever he addresses, well, I don't know about you or about me, he always say, yes, sir. No, sir. And if you know me, I like that kind of thing, you know? So, but he gave the extra day of driving, he gave the blessing. Yes, sir. No, sir. I said, yeah, you like to have a nice meal talking to. So God funded, you know, it is we funded. It didn't know, the system and himself. And these are the memories that you will live forever, you know, just like muscles, those in the gym. Muscles have memory. And our spending time with people that we love, memories are created. And these memories will last forever. Yeah? In our closing thoughts, Bhagwan Krishna told Arjun, Arjun here is you and I, all of us. And the Lord is the scriptures. So when we relate and we read from the scriptures, it is like God telling us, Nikhil, Carl, everyone, it is like God saying to us, and he says, Mamai Vansho Jiva Loke Jiva Bhuta Sanatana Manaha Shashtani Indriyani Prakriti Stani Karshati. He says to Arjun, O Arjun, the soul that is embedded in every human being in this earth, in this world, is part manifestation of my own self. In other words, what he's saying in colloquial language, that the soul of our beloved brother who has left this world, that soul is eternal, and that soul is a part manifestation of the Supreme Lord himself. So in other words, Nikhil, your father will live forever, and he will live forever through you. We as parents will live long in this world through our children. That is why when we say the soul is immortal, it is meant by that. So my dear devotees, the Lord tells many things to Arjun, but I wanted to share that particular thought with you, that the soul that is in all of us, that soul is eternal and part manifestation of the Supreme Lord. As we bow our heads in prayer, we bring closure to our ceremony. As I indicated to you before, it is called Anteshti Sanskar. Anteshti means coming to the end of one cycle and entering into another cycle. And the word sanskar, it means the seed of devotion that is embedded in the depths of a man's consciousness and allow us to differentiate ourselves from animals. And that is why funeral, weddings, certain types of sanskar, christening, initiation, all of these are very important in our lives. Wonderfully, we put our hands together in prayer, bow our heads in prayer. To that Lord we serve, O Anadini Dhano Deva. To that Lord who has no beginning, no middle, and no end. Shankar Chakra Gadadara, which wields the universe within his grasp. Akshaya beyond Pundarika Akshaya. May we, O Lord, take the soul of our beloved brother, pray that unsatiated soul, Moksha Pradu Bhava, and allow that soul to enter and to be given liberation, salvation, nirvana. We pray. Om Krishna Krishna Kripalu Tongati Nangatir Bhava Sansara Navnam Agnanam Prasira Purushottamam. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, oh, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Ramna Satya Hai, Ramna Satya Hai. Bole Vrindavan, dear Ramana ki. Let us all stand as we allow Carl to perform for her final mala for her beloved husband. On this time, of her funeral, she'll always remember that love and adoration. And together that union bring forth the wonderful son as Nikhil. Om Yam Dwari Mahavore Vandane Natamasatre. Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha. My dear devotees, come on, boy, offer your prayers. Just remain standing, my dear devotees, for a few moments, a few seconds again. We just going to finish off our prayers and then we will pray ourselves and then we will leave. As was indicated before, my dear devotees, we live in a time where unprecedented times. Taking it, please, not long, man. Yes, wait for me, don't forget me, wait for me. Unprecedented times, and in this unprecedented times, my dear devotees, we try to do as much as we can do. Take it back upon the left hand, put it in your right hand, put it left hand, hold it in the same hand, go up. Om Shri Paramatmane Namo Namaha. Take it in. Om Rakhu Bodhasya. Take it in. Prajasya Dwara Deshe Panta Nimitam Vishnu Devadu Vaha Isha Devandu Maya Deva Devo Parishna Dham. Nice. You offer all one time here, huh?
Yes.
Nice. Om Surya Chakshur Gacchandu Vatam Vatam Atma Dhyacha Gacha Pritivicha Dharma Mahapova Gacchi Rati Vitam Vikrishi Pratishtita Sharire Om Shri Paramatma Namo Namaha. Om Next one? Yeah. Om Shri Paramatma Namo Namaha. As we put our hands together, we give respect of time, place and situation. Grateful. Next one? Next one? Yeah. Pretty right, I'm pretty right. Yeah. Om Maroko Godrasya. Next one, yeah. Om Pritasya Anil Chatvare Chatvare Chechar Nirtam Ishato Kindu Mayare Deda Vopa Nishnata. Om Shri Vishnave Namaha. Nice. What up? Om Mahapo Vishnamai Vopasana Vrata Mahirana Chakshayo Vashivat Morasata Dehra Jariyana Oshiri Vamadar Tasmara Vamami Vajanojana Ambojanata Om Yamdwari Mahamgori Vandrina Tamsakre Vahalo Karta Mayari Pamiyari Devya Chavo Krishna. Beautiful. What can that? Om Mahapo Vatasya Pukritasya Vishwantau Bhutana Nirdam Vrata Devato Isha Devindu Mayari Devya Chavo Krishna. Offer? Just say, offer and offer. I don't say it much right here. Beautifully. Brick, water, full words, yeah. Final one now, then we're ready to go. Om Shri Krishna Vena, Om Poshna Vaikosa, Rujir Rada, Mehra Raja, Shri Yoshi, Vata Mora, Tata Devaji, Dhyan, Pushri, Kupada, Rata, Sip, Take it in. And I'm going to take several prayers here. Savasya, Sarakarantam, Prit, Dev, Devaku, Ishi, Tipindu, Maya, Yaji, Devo, Krishna. Beautiful. Shri Krishna Vena. My dear devotees, as we prepare ourselves mentally and emotionally to leave, we now pull the guys to move north. Turn around, guys. Right, Anil? Yeah. Young Anil. Yeah, that's his name. And then Anil, John. Where is the man over here? I call the right man. That's the man with his plan. So you want to be very good, Apurisa?
No.
Yeah, right. It's in your jeans, sorry. It's in your jeans, sorry. Ready, guys? Huh? Here we go, guys. So what we'll do is let the box go first and then those who are just follow after, no problem. Ready? Take on the hand. You don't have to go on that? You don't have to go on that?
Ram, you have to follow them. Sure. Good.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Okay, I'll follow. I'll follow. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.